आप करें, आइए आपको दिखाते हैं.
एंड एवरीबडी विश्ड मी वेल फॉर द जॉब, ऑफर्ड मी हेल्प. ही वाज द ओनली वन हु हैड एडवाइस फॉर मी. एंड व्हाट वाज दैट एडवाइस? गिव मी टू पीसेस ऑफ एडवाइस. एक्सीलेंसी, टेक केयर ऑफ योर हेल्थ and spend time with your family, sir. So, Excellency, you know, that's symbolic of the Pakistan-China relationship. It goes beyond diplomacy. It goes beyond formal ties. It is at a person-to-person level. It is a connect at an emotional level. Really appreciate that. I also want to acknowledge the help that China has provided in the difficult times recently. So is Saudi Arabia, and I think soon we will have help coming in from other friendly countries like UAE as well. But here is a promise, Ambassador, that I have been making to everyone, including to the Chinese leadership. Inshallah, Allah, this will be the last time Pakistan reaches out for help just to survive. Okay. And to make that happen, we need a vision. We need a grand plan. Where is all this headed? And the same is true for CPEC also. Just like CPEC is a very important component of BRI, in our opinion, humble opinion, from a Pakistani perspective, perhaps at this point in time, the most important component, or at least the one which is the most tangible on ground. But there is a larger Belt and Road Initiative. There is President Xi's vision of what role he wants to see China play at the global stage in the 21st century. And for us also, if we really want to take advantage of CPEC, we're not at the same stage of development, so we'll scale our ambitions back from the global, but at least we have to have a regional view. And how does CPEC come into play there? And this is something which has been shared with the Chinese leadership, and it is something that has been endorsed and supported by the Chinese leadership. And that's why you saw the announcement a few months back, which created a lot of confusion also. CPEC is obviously a bilateral partnership, that's between Pakistan and China. But jointly, the Chinese and Pakistani leadership have decided that we want to invite third countries for partnership and individual specific projects as well. Because the idea is for this connectivity not just to remain north-south, but also expand westward. And we hope at some point in time, when we have leadership in India, which has a larger vision than trying to seek revenge against real or imaginary slight of history, and is able to think beyond their immediate interests, that it would actually also travel eastward. This will, in my opinion, be, and I think that's an opinion that would be difficult to contradict, and I think that's an opinion shared by many, this is going to be the center of gravity of the global economy of the 21st century. So, and Pakistan cannot be an innocent bystander to all of this. Pakistan cannot just take pleasure in looking at the growth, and we genuinely derive pleasure at the growth that China has exhibited, and you're right, Bakisab, my first visit to China doesn't go back quite 50 years, but it's been at least a couple of decades, and literally every time you visit, you see the place transforming. But we want to be active participants, not just beneficiaries. In my mind, the goal that Pakistan has to set it for itself is not just to be a beneficiary of this regional growth, but to be a contributor to it. So therefore, we have to be working at like three different levels. And that's the thinking that has to drive where we are going. There is the immediate. So when I go back to Q block, there is a reality that I will have.
CPEC پاکستان اور خطے کے لیے اہم منصوبہ ہے. پاکستان اور چین کے تعلقات مضبوط اور مستحکم ہیں. چین، سعودی عرب اور دیگر دوست ممالک نے مشکل وقت میں